Turning now to tensions in the West Philippine Sea, a swarm of Chinese ships seen in the vicinity of Ayungin Shoal. The Philippine Armed Forces says 5 Chinese maritime militia vessels were detected inside Ayungin, while 4 others were spotted outside the shoal.
Sir, normal ba ito, sir, na merong mga Chinese vessels din inside the shoal, inside Ayungin Shoal?
Well, namomotor namin na pumapasok na rin sila this year. Every time na makita namin sila sa loob ng shoal, we deploy our rubber boats to non-confrontationally drive them away.
Ayungin Shoal has been one of the flashpoints of maritime tensions between Beijing and Manila, with the country's lone outpost, the BRP Sierra Madre, grounded there. The international community continues to rally behind the Philippines in the wake of its latest encounters with China. The national security advisors of the U.S., Japan, and the Philippines held a trilateral phone call Wednesday to reaffirm their commitment to freedom of navigation and maintaining regional peace. The U.S. then assured the Philippines of their ironclad alliance in the face of China's growing aggression. U.S. Defense Chief Lloyd Austin also spoke with his Philippine counterpart, Secretary Gilberto Teodoro, to discuss China's latest actions. Austin reiterated Washington's commitment to defend Manila in case of any armed attack under their mutual defense treaty. Austin also sent his condolences to the victims of the deadly blast in Marawi. The U.S. pressing Israel to scale down its offensive in Gaza. The White House says National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan spoke with Israeli officials about possibly switching to a less intense phase of its war with Hamas. The intervention comes after U.S. President Joe Biden said Israel is losing international support in the war due to its indiscriminate bombing of Gaza. Israel's ground offensive was initially concentrated in northern Gaza, but now it's focused on finding senior Hamas leaders believed to be in Khan Yunis, a city in southern Gaza. At least 18,000 Palestinians have been killed since the war began on October 7, when a surprise attack by Hamas killed 1,200 people in Israel. Despite Washington's plea, Israel predicts a drawn-out war against Hamas. During a meeting with White House National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan, Israel's defense minister said it will take several months more for their forces to fully defeat the militants. The war between Israel and Hamas has been raging for over 2 months now.
The Hamas is a terror organization that built itself for a decade to fight Israel. And they build infrastructure under the ground and on the ground, and it is not easy to destroy them. It will take and require a long period of time. It will last more than several months, but we will win and we will destroy them.
A major political victory for Ukraine. The European Union agrees to open membership talks for Kyiv as it tries to gain more support from its allies. The unexpected green light came after Hungarian Prime Minister Viktor Orban, who said he would oppose the deal, appeared to have abstained from the vote. The EU also approved accession talks for Moldova, another country threatened by Russia.
This is a historic moment, and it shows the credibility of the European Union, the strength of the European Union. The decision is made. We open negotiations with Ukraine and with Moldova. We grant status to Georgia and with Bosnia-Herzegovina. We will open negotiations, and a report will be issued in March. And based on that, we'll make a decision in March. This is extremely important. We want to support Ukraine. It's a very powerful political signal. It's a very, very powerful political decision.
On X, Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky hailed the EU's decision, calling it a victory for Ukraine and for all of Europe. The bloc's decision comes at a crucial time for Ukraine, as U.S. military aid for the country becomes more uncertain due to political divisions in Congress. Negotiations to join the EU normally take a decade or longer. It involves major reforms to align a candidate country with EU rules and standards. Russian President Vladimir Putin says there will be peace in Ukraine once Moscow achieves its goals. 2 months shy of the two-year anniversary of the war, Putin reiterated Russia is seeking the denazification, demilitarization, and a neutral status for Ukraine. Putin made those remarks as he gave a four-hour end-of-the-year news conference. Russia has asserted Ukraine is heavily influenced by radical nationalists and neo-Nazi groups, which Kyiv and its Western allies have dismissed as a baseless pretext for the invasion. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, DJ Manotok.
Good morning to our friends at The Rundown. Here are the top stories making the headlines. Meanwhile, this was the ultimate present for a Filipino-American prodigy on her 18th birthday. Giselle Thompson got a birthday cake and her new uniform from her new employers, the Angel City Football Club of the National Women's Soccer League. Angel City FC signed Thompson just a few days before she turned 18 using the NWSL's under-18 mechanism that allows clubs to sign youth players with parental consent. Last season, Angel City took her sister, Alisa Thompson, straight out of high school as a top draft pick at 18 years old.
I've watched Alyssa go through this, and seeing her do it, it's just, like, amazing. So going through with it, too, it's like, even bigger of a deal.
Giselle is part of the U.S. Women's Youth National Team. The defender spent the past season training with Angel City alongside her sister, who is also currently on the U.S. National Women's Team.
I love doing everything with Giselle, and I just always feel more comfortable when she's around me. So having her at practice now all the time and at games and away trips is going to be just like, it's my dream come true, honestly.
And there you have it. The giant parol of Pampanga has now been lit. Merry Christmas!
And finally, we head to San Francisco, where this massive parol, or Philippine Christmas lantern, is proudly displayed in front of the Philippine consulate. It arrived from Pampanga, known to many as the Christmas capital of the Philippines.
This giant parol that we are about to unveil is proudly made in the Philippines. This is a product of the creativity and craftsmanship of the local artisans of Barangay Santa Lucia in San Fernando, the capital city of Pampanga. While it is already massive in size, 8 feet tall and 8 feet wide, this Christmas lantern is only half the size of the parols seen in Pampanga's annual Giant Lantern Festival, or the Ligligan Parol.
And those are the stories making the headlines in the North American region. For more of our TFC News, log on to our website, news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews. Head over to the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel and download our app for your smartphones and tablets. I'm TJ Manotok, back to our friends at The Rundown.